Hello everyone. In this video, we will take a look at how we can create offline first progressive web apps with Angular 6 or higher. So let's get started. First, we need to install or update Angular CLI. So we can go to our command line. And then we can type npm install hyphen g to install it globally, and then we can write angular/cli. So I have already installed it, so I won't do this step. Then after that you install it, you can run ng-v. Now it will show the Angular version. Make sure you have the Angular CLI version 6.0.0 or higher, this one. Now after that we can create new application. So we can go to the desktop. I will create the application here, and then we can write ng new and then the name of the application. So I can say my PWA, and then for styling I will use SAS, and then I will pass the routing flag, so it will give us routing to start with. So after that we can press enter. Now it will create the new application and then install the node module dependencies. Now it may take couple of minutes depending upon the internet speed. So I will be back when it finishes. Alright, now we can change the directory to newly created app. So we can say cd and then my pwa. Now we can open this project inside the editor of our choice. I am using Visual Studio Code here, so I can run code dot. So this will open the project inside the Visual Studio Code, and here if I open the integrated terminal, I can run ng serve, so in short s, and I can pass dash o flag to open it directly inside the browser. Now it will compile the assets and then open the application inside the browser. So here you can see the Angular application. Now let's see how we can add Angular material to our project. So previously in the last versions of Angular CLI, we have to do lot of manual stuff to add Angular material, but this version has support for Angular schematics with which we can add new functionalities to our application, but it does that automatically. So let's see how we can add Angular material. So we can go to our terminal and then we can write ng add at angular/material. Now what it will do is it will install Angular material in our project. So we are getting some error here. If you see this error, then what you can do is you can manually save Angular material and then Angular CDK to our project, and after it is finished then you can run this command. You may not see this error, but if you do, you can run this command, then it will go away. Now after it is installed, you can run ng add Angular material again. Now this time it should work fine. So now what it has done is it has updated some files here and then installed Angular material in our project. Now what you can do is you can go to source control here and see what files have changed. It does that automatically. Maybe you can go to angular.json file. Here you can see in the input array, previously it was empty here in the left side. On the right side you can see what has changed. So it has already included this theme, and then you can see the package JSON has changed and index.html, and also it automatically adds this browser animation module here. So you can see this seems to be working fine now. So we can add it to the source control. Maybe added Angular material, Now we can add Angular material navigation using this schematics. So we can say ng generate Angular material, Angular material, and then we can pass material nav, and here we have to pass the name flag, maybe app nav. Alright, now it will create the files required for the navigation and add it to the app modules. So here are the files that were created. So if we go here, we can say the selector is app nav. It automatically added it to the app modules. So what we can do is we can go to app.component.html and then we can add it here maybe. So we can say app nav. For now we can get rid of this router outlet. So if I save it and I go back to the browser, you can see the navigation here. I think I have misplaced it. Alright, if I save it again, you can see the navigation here. I think we are not seeing the right theme here, so maybe we need to restart the server. So let's do it. Maybe we can run ngs again and then see if it fixes or so. If we go back now and refresh it, you can see we are seeing the right theme now, which is the one we have defined, or which the schematics have already defined in the styles array in the angular.json file. Alright, next maybe we can add tables using the Angular material. So what we can do is we can change material nav to material table, and then here instead of app nav, maybe we can say app table. Now after that we can go to app.nav component, and here after the mat toolbar we can add app table. Now it will show after this toolbar. So here you can see maybe here is our starting application. Now let's see how we can convert it into the PWA so that it will work offline. So if I go to developer tools now and maybe I go to application tab, and here inside of service workers, so if I press offline now and refresh the application, you can see here the application is not working currently. If I change it back to online mode, then it will work. So now we will see how we can add PWA to the application so that it will work offline. So similar to that Angular material schematics, Angular CLI 6.0.0 or higher also provides Angular PWA schematics. So we can say ng, then we can say add, actually it should, it's okay, ng add angular slash pwa. Now it will add the pwa to our project. Now what this command has done, it has created that manifest.json file inside the source directory, and then it also created assets inside of source directory. So it has different icons for the different screens. It also created ngsw-config, so this is service worker config. Here we can define the different files that we need to cache, or maybe we can define this assets directory. So if we want to name it differently, we can do it here. So maybe let's add it to the source control again, Actually, I didn't add that navigation and the table module. So let's add it now. Nav, table, and PWA. Now we need to run our application in production, because service worker will only work in production application. So first we can install the light server that will run our application in production. So we can run it as a dev dependency so that it won't ship with our production application. Now we can go to our package.json, and then we can add new command here for our creating our production code, and then run it with the live server. So we can say start production, and then here we can run the command ng build that will build our app for production, and then we want to open it with the live server. We also need to pass our base directory here. So base directory will be /, in this case, mypwa, the name of our application folder. Now if I save it, and then we can run. Actually, I will close this local server, and then I can run. I will also close this one. npm run, and then start, and then prod flag. So after that, it will open the application or the production application in our browser. So here you can see our application. This is the production application working in the browser. So now if I go back to the console or developer console, and then I go to the application tab, you can see the service worker is running. So now let's refresh the application. Then if I click on the offline mode and then refresh it again, you can see the application is still working. So the application will work without the internet. So this is the use of service workers, and this is how we can add PWA to our application. Thank you.